Yes, we've just begun.
Your daughter has a one in a million voice, Mrs. Carpenter.
Are we really happy?
A story of love, wealth, and success, but little happiness.
If you don't start eating, you're going to make yourself sick.
You're all ganging up on me.
You're not ganging up on me.
It's my life.
Yeah, and you're throwing it away.
Made with the cooperation of Richard Carpenter, the Karen Carpenter story, New Year's Eve on ITV.
Would have been none the wiser. but seriously, we have a lot to thank our parents for. And I don't think I've ever said it properly. They've always been there when I needed them, even after I left home. Without them, I'd never have got the business started. When the bank didn't want to know, it was Dad who came up with the cash. He believed in me. He believed in me when no one else would. How he found the money, I'll never know. So, here's to Peggy and Jack.
Because there are times when you might need money unexpectedly, Commercial Union has a long-term savings plan that lets you take cash out early and still leaves you a lump sum to look forward to.
Thanks, Dad.
Commercial Union. We won't make a drama out of a crisis.
You can take the right sparkling wine anywhere, anytime. Asti Martini. Taste the difference. Crisp, light, fruity bubbles. Deliciously refreshing. Asti Martini. The sparkling wine to enjoy at any time. So, just celebrate the taste.
A very wise decision, sir, one lady owner, 12,000 on the clock, rack and pinion, alloy wheels, twin carbs. You obviously know a great deal about cars.
No.
No.
But I'm getting it inspected by a man who does.
AA Vehicle Inspections. For a small fee, if you're looking for a quality used car, it's all you need to know.
Oh, rumbled. Your suspicions were right, sir. You found a real bargain.
A bargain? I've sold someone a bargain.
I don't care what planet she's from, you're 4 seconds late. Nice wheels.
Shame that to lose them.
Lose them?
He's only gone and bought it.
The Renault 19 Chamade, a new saloon from £7,495. Because Canderel tastes as good as sugar, you won't notice any difference. Except one. Isn't it time you moved over to Canderel?
He ain't heavy. He's my brother.
Tonight at 10:20, the heat of the day.
He's working for the enemy. If you warn him, and we know you warned him, he's no more use to us when we pull him in, you see. That's the end of him.
I'm to sleep with you in order that a man be left free to go on selling his country.
The fact is, I can't bear you out of my sight.
If a man were able to act big in love, he'd be enough of an actor to get away with anything.
Michael York, Patricia Hodge, and Michael Gambon. The heat of the day, tonight.
You're watching London Weekend Television, part of the ITV network, where we now join Sue Carpenter at the studios of ITN to catch up with the latest weekend news.
The news from ITN.
Soviet protests turn to violence. Police open fire on a crowd. ITN finds the priest who sparked the Romanian revolution. Tory attack on the dangers of scruffy Britain. And the goal that keeps Liverpool as New Year leaders. Good evening. Demonstrators in the troubled Soviet Republic of Azerbaijan are tonight said to be in control of the city of Jalilabad after overcoming police who'd opened fire on the crowd. Reports say that 150 people were injured and a teenager shot dead before the crowd forced the police to drop their guns and run. In the last few minutes, official radio has said 37 people have been arrested and 63 soldiers injured.
As communists met in the Azerbaijani capital on Thursday night, thousands of demonstrators were on the streets of Jalalabad protesting against them. When news reached delegates that police had opened fire, the session broke up. It's now clear one teenager was killed and 152 protesters injured. Tonight on Soviet television, there was no mention of the bloodshed. Local journalists say neither the communists nor the police are in control. There's been a score of demonstrations in Azerbaijan this year, and there's mounting resentment at decisions and orders handed down from Moscow. The latest protests were against a new and unpopular communist leader imposed by the Kremlin. There were demonstrations in Lithuania as well this week. Mr. Gorbachev is now assailed by protest from north and south. The Kremlin appealed again today for unity in the Soviet Union. But as each of the republics pushes for more freedom from Moscow, that unity is looking increasingly fragile. Bill Neely, ITN, Moscow.
The priest whose arrest sparked the Romanian revolution and the downfall of dictator Nicolae Ceaușescu has described how he tried to calm the situation rather than provoke violence. Police had tried to arrest Laszlo Turkish in Timișoara. When crowds tried to protect him, the police opened fire, killing hundreds. In an exclusive interview with ITN, Turkish says he wants a role in the new government.
The village of Minău lies isolated 6 miles up a dirt track deep in the Transylvanian mountains. Father Laszlo Turkish, his pregnant wife and three-year-old son are now being protected by the Romanian army. Father Turkish says he never wanted to become a national figure. During the demonstrations in Timișoara 2 weeks ago, he tried to calm the crowd.
They were shouting, down with Ceaușescu, down the communist regime. I tried to calm them and I tried to send them off. To avoid the consequences.
They were arrested by Securitat men in their church in Timișoara at 3 o'clock in the morning.
The doors of the church were broken and many of the militias and securists ran in, and in a brutal mood they have taken off. They have taken us off. They have beaten me and pushed my wife.
They were driven to Minău and interrogated. The Securitat wanted Father Turkish to confess to being a Western agent.
They didn't care that my wife was pregnant and she was still ill. And is true that they didn't beat us in this period, in some days that followed, but the psychological pressure was unbearable.
When Ceaușescu fell, the villagers hid the couple for 24 hours until the army arrived. Now this small-town preacher is a member of the national government and is being hailed as a hero of his country. But he says all he really wants is to continue with his church work. Glenn O'Glaza, ITN, Transylvania in Romania.
The new Romanian Prime Minister has been explaining why Ceaușescu was executed after being put on trial. Petre Roman said there was a plot to free him, and his death meant a quicker end to fighting.
According to the Romanian army, this man is one of President Ceaușescu's secret police assassins. He was arrested outside the building where the new Prime Minister and several key members of the government are based. After a brief gun battle, a second prisoner is brought in. The soldiers say he too is a member of the hated Securitate. On one prisoner, they find an identity card, according to the officer it's a Securitate licensed to kill. Today, the principal target for the assassins, Romania's new prime minister, told ITN he's learnt to live with the knowledge he's at the top of a death list.
It's a problem which I'm not interested in, really. We lived with the terror, we fought every time with the terror, and I don't feel that. Maybe other people now are concerned about that, me not.
In an exclusive interview, the Prime Minister said the war against the secret police has been won.
The military problem is practically solved.
When do you think the shooting on the street will end?
As soon. We hope just now.
Despite his confidence as the Prime Minister and his advisers plan their country's future, there are bodyguards at his door and an army outside the building. Paul Davies, ITN, Bucharest.
Here, the Deputy Prime Minister, Sir Geoffrey Howe, is tonight warning of the dangers of scruffy Britain. In a message to his local party, he called for a joint initiative using public and private money. The Prime Minister, in her New Year's message, says the 80s have been a decade of solid achievement.
There seems a sharp contrast in the vision of Britain held by Sir Geoffrey Howe and his Prime Minister. In her New Year's statement, Mrs. Thatcher said the overwhelming message of the last 10 years was that socialism had failed. She said conservative policies of freedom and enterprise had produced a decade of solid achievement, and she promised more of the same policies, with the priorities of beating inflation, improving public services, and cleaning up the environment. Sir Geoffrey Howe didn't contradict any of that. Indeed, he went out of his way to praise Mrs. Thatcher's inspired leadership, but he condemned many aspects of British life. He talked of a basically innumerate and sometimes illiterate educational system, of shoddy bus stations and dirty trains, of litter and scruffiness in far too many of our public places, which were the breeding ground of delinquency, and of the need to reduce the numbers of apparently destitute teenagers or handicapped on Britain's streets. In other parts of the message, he echoed Mrs. Thatcher's comments, but those kind of criticisms underline the different approaches of Prime Minister and her deputy. Mr. Kinnock has entered the new year with an attack on the government, which he said had driven Britain into debt. He also said public divisions in the government were only a hint of the conflicts raging inside the cabinet.
President Bush has admitted that American troops made a mistake in searching the home of a Nicaraguan diplomat in Panama. He said it was a screw-up that shouldn't have happened. The Nicaraguan said the American raid had violated diplomatic immunity.
The United States admit that the nighttime raid on this luxury home was a mistake. The Nicaraguan ambassador said today that the troops had ransacked his house and taken $3,000 in cash while searching for weapons. They'd also manhandled his relatives.
My brother called me at the embassy and told me that the house had been surrounded and that the troops had ordered everyone to come out with their hands up or they would be shot. And they really meant it because they started shooting into the air.
The Americans said the residence wasn't listed as his official home and the raid had uncovered an arsenal.
Four Uzis, machetes, a variety of magazines, small weapons, large amounts of ammunition.
The weapons were later returned, but Nicaragua's president, Daniel Ortega, denounced the Americans as common criminals as he ordered 20 U.S. diplomats to leave his country. After 3 days of blasting rock music at Noriega, they finally turned it off. The only visible result had been some priestly aerobics in the embassy garden.
In effort to break the deadlock here, Panama's Catholic bishops have appealed to the Vatican to release Noriega to the Panamanian authorities. They say he's just a crook and doesn't deserve sanctuary on political or humanitarian grounds. Ken Rees, ITN, Panama City.
Hong Kong police have warned they may open fire if they're attacked by Vietnamese boat people trying to resist being forced home. They say the boat people are planning to take hostages and burn detention centres in protest.
This display of homemade weapons seized at the Chi Ma Wan camp shows how close the police operation had come to ending in a bloodbath. 430 weapons were found, including spears, iron hooks, and machetes. The officer who ordered his riot police to storm the detention center said the Vietnamese had repeatedly refused to allow an orderly search. He had feared for the lives of his men and had been prepared to use live ammunition.
If that had taken place on the streets of Hong Kong, then
the police officer who has offered that degree of violence would have been justified, in my opinion, in opening fire.
The camp is officially off limits, but we managed to land on the island today. Order has been restored, though there were some small signs in these raised fists of the defiance that is so prevalent here. These were angry voices from men who said they preferred death to deportation.
They want to fight with the police if the police come to fuck them to back to Vietnam.
So the mood at this camp today seems to be one of fear, but also of determination to resist forced repatriation to Vietnam, whatever the cost. Norman Rees, ITN, at the Chi Ma Wan camp, Lanto Island.
China has attacked Britain's decision to give more than 200,000 Hong Kong Chinese the right to live in Britain. The Foreign Ministry said Britain's plan was a gross violation of its own solemn commitment to returning the colony to Chinese rule in 1997. In Jerusalem, 70 people were injured and 45 arrested after Israeli police clashed with demonstrators at a peace rally. Trouble began soon after 20,000 Arabs, Israelis and Europeans formed a human chain around the old city. Police moved in after Palestinians began throwing stones at them. Now, with news of the last Football League matches of the decade and the rest of today's sport, here's Giles Smith.
Kenny Dalglish's Liverpool go into the 90s where they've been a lot of the 80s on top of the First Division. They beat Charlton 1-0 today. Against the bottom of the table strugglers at Anfield, they were well below strength and could only manage one goal. It came from Staunton's cross and was beautifully taken by John Barnes. Ian Rush had a penalty saved in the second half, but the Reds are still 4 points clear. The clash between second and third placed Aston Villa and Arsenal was won 2-1 by the Birmingham side, their first poached by Andy Platt. In the second half, Daly's cross found Arsenal furiously appealing for offside, and Derek Mountfield had all the time in the world to head over Lukic. A minute from time, Adams got the goal Arsenal had been threatening all through the second half, but it was too late to stop Villa jumping over the champions into second place. Elsewhere, Brian Clough celebrated his 1,000th match as a manager with a 3-2 win over Spurs, for whom Gary Lineker got both goals. In Scotland, Graham Souness's Rangers go into the new year on top of the Premier Division, even though they only drew with Hibs today. Great Britain captain Ellery Hanley celebrated his MBE in the New Year honours by leading Wigan to the final of Rugby League's Regal Trophy. They beat Castleford 24-10 in the semi-final and now meet Halifax in 2 weeks' time.
Wigan's quick lead was never really threatened. Their first try, Lydon diving onto a Gregory through ball, showed up one Castleford weakness. Their second was an embarrassing mistake from the Castleford fullback Larder. Betts carried it over for the easiest of scores. 20-0 down in the second half, Castleford finally found a Wigan weakness to explore. Larder made up for his early mistake by finishing the move. But Wigan weren't about to throw away their chance of a fifth final in this competition. Hanley for once stayed on the sidelines as Bell fed Marshall to confirm the victory. Ellis got a second Castleford consolation at the end, but Wigan go on to the final against lowly Halifax, the overwhelming favourites. Peter Staunton, ITN Sport, Headingley.
Peter Elliott beat Steve Cram today to prove the selectors right in sending him to the Commonwealth Games and not his great rival. Although the 2,000-metre clash at Durham wouldn't have changed the controversial decision, Elliott badly wanted to win. He'd led most of the way, and with 200 metres to go, moved up another gear to easily hold off Cram, who was just pipped on the line by Tony Morell. Finally, no less than 26 sportsmen and women were in the New Year's honours list, but only one of them could react like this.
Very, very, very forward-looking, going to Buckingham Palace, you know, with my top hat and, you know what I mean, bowing and that. I'm looking very forward because it's a, not everybody gets that, you know. It's a nice thing to get because I used to work on a building site, being a metal polisher, and it's a nice thing to get.
And that's all for the moment. We'll be back tomorrow at 1. Good evening.
Good evening. Quite a cold night ahead, but that's too late to alter the fact that as a whole, 1989 looks like being the warmest year ever recorded. These are tonight's temperatures, a frost in parts of the north, as you can see. Elsewhere, temperatures generally just above freezing, but it'll still feel quite cold, especially with those moderate southeast winds. Apart from that, tonight fairly uneventful, a few spots of rain or drizzle around the coasts, especially up in the northwest, and perhaps the odd fog patch in the south too. Tomorrow starting off fairly quiet too, a lot of cloud around, but apart from that, most places dry. A thicker cloud in the northwest, again producing a few spots of rain. And as we go through the day, two things happening: the rain edging a little further east and perhaps turning to a bit of wet snow on the mountains by the evening, and brightening up a touch in the south, and that'll help temperatures to rise a fraction above today's figures, but still fairly cold, especially in eastern parts of Britain and the northwest with strong winds. That's it from me. Good night.
Good evening. Now we'll take a look at the weather details for the LWT area. And the very quiet overcast weather is set to last until the new year. Tonight will remain cloudy, with most of the region staying dry, save for a few spots of drizzle in the east of the region. Temperatures should stay above freezing, around 2 Celsius, 36 Fahrenheit. Even so, the light easterly wind will make it feel quite cold. Moving on to Sunday now, New Year's Eve, it'll be very light today, generally cloudy, with only a few bright spells. The temperatures will reach a maximum 5 degrees Celsius, 41 Fahrenheit, which is a couple of degrees below average for the time of year. The winds will be mainly from the east, mostly light, but still strong enough to make it feel bitterly cold. By the latter part of tomorrow, there'll be rain coming in from the west of the country and moving eastwards during New Year's Day. And with that, I'll wish you a very good night.
Bringing up children is the most important job in the world.
Two children become the centre of a tug of love when a mixed marriage goes sour.
I'd do anything for a man that made me laugh.
Oh, please, can we never go out?
The emotional upheaval brought on by infidelity.
Sonia, where's my wife?
She's just popped out.
Stolen, set in England and Pakistan.
My husband has taken my children.
He's obviously taken them out of the country.
He's stolen them.
Starting next Friday at 9.
New drama into the 90s. Wednesday at 8, Inspector Morse is back.
It's a hoax. Someone playing tricks, that's all.
There's no name. Were the others anonymous?
Is it you, darling? Imogen? Please, darling, don't do this again.
Here! Arson! Murder, maybe?
No murderer can shake off Inspector Morse. Back for a new series Wednesday at 8 on ITV.
Drama, intrigue, and a star-studded cast next tonight in the heat of the day.
If you lose your home and contents in a fire, Guardian Royal Exchange will put you up in a hotel. But how many hotels will put up with your pets? So when Guardian Royal Exchange settle your claim, we settle your kennel fees too. That way, no one gets left out in the cold. Guardian Royal Exchange. It's our policy to improve your policy.
If your car is running on 4-star, it could perhaps use Esso Super Plus Unleaded right now, without converting the engine. Unlike ordinary unleaded, it has the same octane power as Esso 4-star, so there's no loss of performance. It's cheaper than our 4-star, and environmentally, it makes more sense. Esso Super Plus Unleaded. You may be able to switch to it right now, without converting your engine. check with our brochure.
If you're a sinus sufferer, there's no such thing as a common cold. Mucron is a powerful decongestant. A single tablet will help clear your head and relieve sinus pain. Mucron, a decongestant for the uncommon cold.
At the Texas sale, we've £500,000 worth of extra savings every day till Tuesday. Well, good news always travels fast.
This is a pint of ordinary lager. And this is low-alcohol lager. Now, some low-alcohol lagers are around one-third the strength of ordinary lager. So three of these could contain the same amount of alcohol as one of those. Now, this is Caliber from Guinness. And because it's alcohol-free, you can drink as much as you like.
You're watching London Weekend Television, part of the ITV network. Now, the heat of the day.